Hi everyone, and welcome to this video where I will show you the UNSA pre-processing capabilities regarding laminated composites. The first step of pre-processing in UNSA is to import a CAD or CAE model. After that, you can apply the layup information or easily create and modify layers. Preview the effective engineering properties before the output and finally generate an extensive report of the laminate property. A composite layout is created which can be found in the UNSA launcher window, since a respective XML file is available upon installation. First things first, we need to load a model in UNSA and then browse to the property list to find a suitable property to isolate and modeled as composite. A new laminate property is created through the property list and is used for the management of composite structure in UNSA. Once the property is created, you need to assign it to existing elements using the Apply option and select the elements or property that you need. You can easily check the material orientation of the elements through the GUI and using the function Material Orientation, which is available in the DEX module, to change it. There are five different available types that you can specify the material orientation. One of them is by selecting edges or curves in your model, and by confirming your selection, see directly the result. A dedicated tool that supports laminated composites is available in UNSA for all the decks. The laminate tool makes it easy to handle laminate property attributes and create, view, copy, and modify layers. Massive modification of all entities' attributes can be achieved by selecting the entities you want and by pressing right-click in the attribute's name, modifying the existing value. Moreover, you can also massive modify the content of selected layers. You can easily add, remove, or define a group of layers by selecting a region from your model and apply it to all of them. You can use the options of copy, mirror copy, or multiple copy to one or group of layers in order to expedite the build-up of your laminate model. Also, you can organize and group the layers in sequences, which are hierarchical entities and they do not affect any deck output. Layer templates can be defined in the same way as layers and may be referenced by layers to inherit the area and attributes from a template to many layers. In this way, the lamination process can be accelerated, as layers with common area do not need to be defined multiple times, but refer to the same template. The activation and definition of the attributes that are going to be inherited by the layers is needed. The assignment of a template to a layer is done by filling in the template's ID, or by pressing the question mark key in the template field of a layer. The draping tool, which is embedded in the laminate tool, can be used to define orientations of single and merged layers. Three algorithms for the determination of layer orientations are available. To apply draping, it is necessary to first define the rosette for each layer from the Rosettes tab, and after that, specify the draping parameters and the draping algorithm that is going to be used. The fishnet algorithm is suitable for woven fabrics. The algorithm simulates fiber shearing that occurs when a woven fabric is draped on a geometric surface, and a preview of angle deviation is available. The algorithm is also capable of calculating both warp and weft directions when merged layers are used to model woven fabrics. In this occasion, two layers are used, one for each fiber direction. The Calculate Thickening option, which is available for layer pairs only, calculates the amount of thickening at areas where shearing occurs. The differences of fishnet and sliding algorithms are obvious, since the sliding algorithm is suitable for single unidirectional layers, and usually the fibers of unidirectional layers are oriented along one direction, while the fishnet algorithm is suitable for woven fabrics, and both warp and weft directions are calculated. A wizard-based tool, Laminate Convert, is available in UNSA as a plugin. The purpose of this tool is to convert shell laminates to per-ply shells, thick shells, or solid element, and all that with selectable connection elements at the interface between layers. The available connections are beams, cohesives, and contacts. The first step of the wizard is the selection of the desired type of conversion. After that, define the type that the structural elements are going to be connected, and finally, the property assignment that will be performed after the conversion. Three options are available. The first option is one laminate that will assign one laminate property to all resulting elements. The second, one laminate per layer option that will assign laminate properties for each layer of resulting elements. And the last, one section per layer that will assign normal section properties for each layer of resulting elements. Laminate data can also be imported into UNSA in two ways, either by a DEC input or by mapping a source file to a target mesh. For the second way, a dedicated function, ResultsMapper, is available in UNSA. The ResultsMapper functionality may be used to apply laminate information from a source file to a target mesh. The source can either be a solver file or a file containing lamination information. Many source formats are supported in UNSA, such as Nostrun, Elastina, Pumcrush, Abacus, Ansys, Radios, Permis, Simulate, Fibersim, or Moldflow. Once the procedure is finished, you can see through the laminate tool that all the information has been transferred to the model. Before finish the whole procedure of built up a laminate composite model, you can preview the zones of different stacking in your model and get extensive information of each element from any zone in the UNSA info window. Also, you can generate an extensive report for a laminate property through the laminate tool, containing layer information and 3D curves of layer outlines. Browsing in the report, you can see in detail zones and layers stacking diagram. ABD matrices. A preview of the zones. A preview of layers. The stacking, and finally, the polar plots of engineering properties.